Hello students, welcome to my channel. Today in this video we will see the introduction of our second chapter, fractions and decimals. Already you have some basic knowledge about fractions. Okay, here fraction is nothing but a part of whole. Okay, here just imagine this is like a cake. Okay, a cake which is in round shape. This is a cake, and now I am dividing this cake into 8 equal parts, because there are 8 friends are there and they have to share one cake. Okay, so I divided the cake into 8 equal parts. So now for each one they get one piece. To a 8 friends are there and each one will get one piece, right? So what is the portion of the cake? Does each one will get one piece out of 8 pieces, right? So this is the fraction. What is this? A part of the cake, no? So part of whole, that means part of a complete, part of a complete or part of a whole is nothing but the fraction. Okay, in the fraction the number which is above this line is called numerator. What is this? Numerator. And the number below the line is called denominator. Numerator and denominator. Okay, so fraction is nothing but a part of whole. And here you can see one biscuit, right? Now if I divided this biscuit into 2 pieces, this is 1/2 and this is 1/2, exactly half. Okay, just imagine exactly these two parts are equal and this part value is 1/2 and this is 1/2. Okay, so and here I'm taking here 4 chocolates. Okay, here 4 chocolates are there and now I am taking 1 chocolate. So what is the part I got in chocolates? 1/4. I took 1 out of 4. So what is the portion of the chocolate I got? 1/4. So like this you can write the fractions. Okay, so I think you understand this. So fraction is a part of a whole number, that means fraction is a part of a complete number. Okay, so in fraction, if a by b is the fraction, what a is called? Numerator, and b is called denominator, right? So if this numerator is less than the denominator, that means if the fractions are like this 1/2 and 3/5 and 7/9, like this. Okay, that means here in each case numerator is less than the denominator. Numerator is less than the denominator. If the fractions are like this, okay, if numerator is less than denominator, then these type of fractions are called proper fractions. What are these? Proper fractions. And if the fractions are like three by two, 5/3, and 9/7. So if you observe, in each case numerator is more than the denominator, right? Greater than the denominator. So here numerator is greater than the denominator. So the fractions like this are called improper fractions. What are these? Improper fractions. So fractions are two types basing on the nature of numerator and denominator. If numerator is less than the denominator, those fractions are called proper fractions, and numerator is greater than the denominator, those are improper fractions. Proper means whatever it is, it should be in an order, the or beautiful, whatever it is. In Telugu proper we say sariga. Okay, sariga ani cheptam. So proper means it should be less than number. Okay, so the number which is above the line should be less than the number below the line. So if numerator is less than denominator, that is proper, and if numerator is greater than denominator, that is improper. Okay, and if you observe here, I just draw two figures in figure 1 and figure 2. So after looking these pictures, what will be more nice or more beautiful? Sorry, it's not beautiful, but what is nice to see? The first one, because here the head is very little, right? So it is nice to see, and here the head is more, that means it is proper. The head is nice, and the head is smaller one, and it is matched with the body of the figure, and so the picture is proper, that means it looks nice. Okay, so coming to here the head is bigger than the body, right? So it's not nice, and it doesn't look properly, right? So you can just remember, proper fraction means the head should be small. What is the head? Head is nothing but numerator. Improper fraction means the head should be more, greater, okay, biggest. That is here, what is the head? Head is nothing but numerator. So what is proper fraction? If numerator is less than the denominator, that is proper, that means head should be small. And what is improper fraction? The head should be big or greater. So if numerator is greater than the denominator, then that is improper fraction. Okay students, now just observe this. So in the first one, 1 by 2, 7 by 2, 5 by 2 and 9 by 2. So in each fraction, what is the denominator? 2. That means denominator is same in each case. So the fractions like this, the fractions having the same denominator are called like fractions. What we call these? Like fractions. The fractions having same denominator are called like fractions, or otherwise like this also we can say, the fractions having same numerator, the fractions having same denominator, or the fractions having same numerator are called like fractions. Okay, and if you observe these fractions, what about the denominator? Here the denominator 2, and here the denominator 6, and here the 5, and here we'll take as 8. So all the denominators are different, right? So these denominators are different. So these type of fractions are called unlike fractions. What are these? Unlike fractions. So what are the like fractions? The fractions having same denominator are called like fractions. And what are unlike fractions? The fractions having different denominators, or otherwise the fractions having, the fractions do not have same denominator are called unlike fractions. Okay, so these are like fractions and unlike fractions, and we have seen proper fraction and improper fraction also. So here we have one biscuit and half biscuit, right? So we have one and half biscuit. Here we have one and half biscuit. So I can write as one and half like this, right? One and half biscuit. So this is also fraction. 1 by 2 is the fraction and 1 is the complete part, right? This is fraction and this is complete part. So the fractions like this are called mixed fraction, because this is the combination of fraction and whole number. So that's why this is called mixed fraction. So mixed fraction, 3 and half mixed fraction, 4, 1 by 7 mixed fraction. So what is mixed fraction? A complete part and the fraction. Okay, so a number and the fraction is wrote side by side, that is mixed fraction. So now we can convert a mixed fraction into an improper fraction. So how we will convert? You see, here what is in the denominator? 2 is in the denominator. So write that 2. Okay, and starts with the denominator only 2. First multiplication into this complete number 1. Next plus numerator. So 2 into 1, 2 plus 1 by 2. So it is 3 by 2. So 1 and half means 3 by 2. Okay. So what is half in 3 rupees? 1 rupees and 5 paise, right? So 1 and half equals to 3 rupees. Okay. So you can write this improper fraction because numerator is greater than the denominator. So 3 by 2. Now we can convert this into improper also. So just by division. So 2 ones are 2, remainder here 1. So first take this quotient 1 and next remainder 1 by divisor. That means with what number we divided. So that is 1 by 2. Okay. Now we will see another example also. 3 1 by 7 is the mixed fraction. So how can we convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction? First multiplication and next addition, right? So denominator 7 and 7 into 3 plus 1, that is 21 plus 1. So that is 22 by 7. What is this value? 22 by 7. So 22 by 7, how can we write as mixed fraction? So take 22 and divide with 7. 7 3 is 21 and remainder is 1. So how can we write this as a mixed fraction? So first we have to write the quotient, that is 3, and then remainder 1, and then divisor 7. So 3 1 by 7. So like this we can convert a mixed fraction into improper fraction and an improper fraction into mixed fraction. Okay, so if you know these basic conversions or calculations, you can very easily solve these chapter problems. Okay, so here you see, here 3 fractions are there. So 1 is 3 by 6 and 2 by 4 and 6 by 12. So these are 3 fractions. So here you see the numerator and denominator have common factors. That means numerator and denominator comes in single table, one table. That is 3 ones and 3 twos. So this value 1 by 2, right? And here also 2 ones and 2 twos. So this is 1 by 2. So here 6 ones and 6 twos, 1 by 2. That means all these fractions, after simplifications, we got 1 by 2 only, right? So the fractions like this are called equivalent fractions. What are these? Equivalent fractions. That means after simplifications we are getting same value. So such type of fractions are called equivalent fractions. Okay. So in solving the problems we use this concept also. We convert the given fraction into equivalent fraction. Okay. So after that we solve the problem. So this is the basic introduction to our second chapter's fractions and decimals. And in this video I just introduced fractions only, and decimals introduction is separate video. Okay, please follow my channel regularly and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.